Hello, this is Amethyst Lunatari, and welcome to What Never Was. This is a free game on Steam. If I remember, I'll put a link in the description. Otherwise, just look up What Never Was, and you'll find it. It's a very short adventure game. It's by Acke, if I'm pronouncing that right, Hallgren. This is his first self-published game. This is his first, like, overall game that he's made himself. But he's also been a level designer and writer for Rage 2, Division, and a few other games. And this came out in early 2019, and really I'm just expecting, like, an hour or so of gameplay, so let's check it out. Now the options, unfortunately, reset every time. I'm gonna put everything down to around here, so you can hear a sound that happens when you do that. And when you move this, you hear her voice, which is interesting because then you can adjust the voice, which is a very good idea. I haven't seen that in any games that I've played, so I really like that idea. The only problem is it's lacking a bit in the execution because none of this, what you're doing here, changes the sound in the intro. The intro is short, however, because the game is short, obviously. And unfortunately, everything changes, everything resets if you quit out and come back in. So, like key bindings and everything like that, like I'm going to change in the control section, those will all be wiped out and will just reset and you'll have to do them again. Don't know why, but you can hear what she says, so I think it's interesting what she says here. She says a couple sentences.
Hey there, I'm Sarah, and this is my voice, I guess. So.
Oh wait, it resets.
Hey there, I'm Sarah, and this is my voice, I guess. So, you'll be hearing a lot of this, unless you turn the volume down, but you're not gonna, are you? I mean, you're gonna want to hear all the important thoughts I have about everything, right? I mean, it's up to you, but I leave it on, because you might miss out.
But of course, so we just turn it down a little bit so they can hear me when she happens to talk. This was like this by default, not changing that. This I am changing because I actually use a tactical board to do my stuff. I think this stays the same, that stays the same. Zoom, I'll put with that. Inventory, I'll just make I with the keyboard. And should I hold crouch? Does this only have to do with... I wonder if this has to do with the gamepad here, I'm not sure. With the controller. I'm gonna not hold crouch. We can always change it. So we have inspect and interact. Which is interesting. Alright. So I'm gonna shut up for the intro because she's gonna be blasting over my voice anyway. It's really short, so here we go.
Hey Mom, where are you? Wait, what? So you're not coming? But I'm already here. I know, but Mom, don't we owe it to Grandpa to... Yeah, I know, it's just... What? You can't sell the clock? Grandpa's had that for years. Okay, whatever. It's fine. I can just start clearing up my boxes and then, I don't know, we can come back tomorrow and do the rest? Yeah, bye. I'm really going to miss you, Grandpa. All right. Let's do this.
Let's do it. Now this really reminds me of another game I played, which I can't remember the name. Kate or something? I'll try to put a subtitle, a little caption down there. with what it was. It was like two or three episodes, really. An hour and something to play it, I think. Fun game, though, and this seems really the same, where you're walking around in an attic and looking at stuff. Wait, is it because she can't go this way? This is supposed to... Did I do that? Oh, it's not letting me... I must have messed something up. There we go. Sorry, guys. I guess that's also Zoom. Okay. She moves slow. But the mouse look is really crazy.
It's going to take forever to sort through all these. Grandpa sure did like his books. Nah. It's going. The Hero with a Thousand Faces by Joseph Campbell. These books are all so old. Hey, wait. Is that the biography of George Lucas?
Is that a biography of George Lucas? Now I'm just clicking on the same book and just give me random stuff.
Fairies by Brian Froud and Alan Lee. Celtic Myths and Legends. Celtic Myths and Legends. These books are all so old. Fairies by Brian Froud. The Hero with a Thousand... Fairies by The Hero with a Thousand Faces. It's going to... Celtic Myths and Legends. These books are all so old. Hey, wait. Is that the biography of George Lucas? I'm sure some of these are worth keeping, but I'm not going to sit down and sort through them right now.
Why the hell not?
Maps. Lots of maps. Grandpa loved reading maps. And making maps.
Okay, so you've got multiple responses for everything.
I wonder how many of these he charted or drew himself. I loved when we drew maps of places we made up together. We draw our own cities, fantasy villages, and the like. Maps.
Oh.
Lots of maps.
I interrupted something.
I'm sure some of these are worth... I'm sure some of these are worth keeping. I'm sure some of these are worth keeping. But I'm not going to sit down. Ah, the old gramophone. I used to put this on for Grandpa after dinner, and we'd sit and listen to it together. I've never been much into swing music, but it was our little tradition.
Swing music, huh?
Ah, the old gramophone.
So I am toggling crouch already. Alright.
Oh, Grandma's cello. So this is where it ended up.
We can jam with this.
Oh, Grandma's cello. So this is where it ended up. I really wish I knew if that was in tune or not.
Doesn't sound like it. Might be.
Yeah. Enough of that. It's a banker's lamp. Probably really old, but in great condition. It's a banker's lamp.
Can I open these drawers?
A desk drawer. A desk drawer. It's locked. It's locked.
It's locked. It's locked.
A desk drawer. It's locked. It's locked. It's locked.
I guess it's locked.
It's locked. It's locked. It's locked.
Guess I know.
It's locked.
They're all locked.
It's locked. It's locked.
Oh, that one's not locked.
An open desk drawer.
Huh. Can I...
An open desk drawer. An open desk drawer.
Well, I opened it. I can't do anything with what's inside. Huh. It's very anticlimactic.
Oh, Grandpa's old travel diary. Seems like a few pages are missing. Pele, goddess of fire. Why was Grandpa researching Hawaiian myths? I should see if I can find the missing pages before moving this.
Why can't we take it with us and then put the pages in?
He sure could draw, though. I mean, look at that goddess dragon thing.
He drew that.
Oh, great. I should see if I can find the missing pages before moving this.
Find the pages. Got it.
It's a magnifying glass. For magnifying things.
Yeah.
It's a magnifying glass. For magnifying things.
Was that her reflection?
It's a magnifying glass. I'm only here to pick up my stuff, but maybe I'll grab this later. I'm only here to pick... Aw, it's a picture of us. Grandpa, you sweet old bastard.
All right, we can zoom. Okay.
I'm going to miss hearing about all of your adventures.
You better look at this, too. Pele, goddess of fire. I can almost read that. Water goddess. Meant to be something raised as a water goddess? Praised? The goddess Pele reminds us that even fiery eruptions and emotional upheavals are followed by new life and change. As an archetype, Pele is a passionate and creative force that transforms and rebuilds the landscapes of our lives. Oh my god. It's kind of like the light is making it harder to read, believe it or not. Pele, okay, meant to be raised as a water goddess, had to flee from her older sister Namaska Dangerous. Need to study up on Hawaiian deities. Seems. Pele fought many Hawaiian goddesses? Apparently often with jealousy as main reason. This, however, can be just as much folktale as it can be true. We'll see when I meet her. Found in library? I don't know.
It's Grandpa on one of his expeditions. He sure was adventurous. I wonder where this is. And what Grandpa was doing there.
So I guess Grandpa passed away.
It's Grandpa. Aw. It's a picture of... This must be from Grandma and Grandpa's wedding. They look so sweet together. This must be... I'm only here to pick up my stuff. Fairies. By... The hero with a thousand... Celtic... He's the hero with
all
a
these books
faces.
The same.
A desk drawer.
Ooh, I can get this.
A torn out page. This seems to belong to the diary. What's this?
It's a torn out page.
Could this be one of the diary pages? This looks like one of the diary pages. It looks like a torn out page.
You picked up journal page to look in your inventory. Oh. Okay, I got stuff already. It's 4 or 5? Are we missing a... We're missing a digit. A Matson flip phone. It's a year old, but still works pretty great. I'm not in a hurry to upgrade, even though the new smartphones look pretty nifty. Well, maybe I would be if I could afford one. Can I actually move? Oh, I can. Awesome. Thursday, August 20th, yeah. Student ID from my school. Oh, that's her. Sarah Elizabeth Wright. Birthday, I guess? Yeah, December 22nd, 1990. What, the date of issuing or the expiry date? I can't see. Can I zoom in on that, too? No. A student ID from my school. I'm still not quite sure if studying botanics and biology is right for me, and God knows Mom doesn't think so. But I like nature, and I like the idea of maybe one day fixing the planet and winning the Nobel Prize or something. or setting up a flower shop. You know, whichever. Also not the best picture, but yeah, that's me. Oh, she was holding this in her hand when she came in, right after the intro. A necklace I got from Grandpa when I turned 10. He joked that it was magical and it would keep me safe from monsters and such under my bed, and I believed him for the longest time. I've worn it since, and now that he's gone, I don't think I'll ever stop wearing it. Journal page number 5. Ooh. Oh, does each page have to do with a different, like, item from folklore? Alright, so journal page 5. Elfsten. Also sometimes known as troll stones. Oh, this is actually... this is the icon that Steam puts on your desktop if you, you know, elect to have a shortcut on desktop. The icon is of this, but it's in color. It's like a purplish, bluish color. Alright, also known as troll stones, the subject of Scandinavian folklore, normal rocks with holes in them the size of an acorn were considered lucky, otherworldly, and useful. Hung from the necks of livestock, it would protect them and their farmers alike from malicious predators, trolls, and even incubi. In some tales, the owner of a true elfsten is also able to see the otherwise invisible common troll through the hole of the rock. While several of these were on display, only one of them looked to be the one I was looking for. Carved in a way that no average jeweler could, and with ore in place of where a hole should be. I didn't acquire it through the most honest of means, but no one came to harm, and I'm sure its disappearance won't be noticed. I do wonder how it fits into all of this, though. I must study it thoroughly. Grandpa stealing stuff. That's a bad grandpa.
These books are all so old.
It's the same.
Hey, wait. Is that the biography of George Lucas? Fairies. By Brian.
Yeah. It's going to take forever to sort through all these.
No books.
Grandpa sure did like his books.
So let's try to zoom in again. Can I get any of these or any of these pages? No. Okay. I don't know what could be... oh, it was already... ah! You picked up journal page. Number 2. It seems no coincidence that both the resting place of Pele and Pariacaca would happen to be in mountains. The trek has gone well. Symbol of water? The alchemic symbol of water. Oh, this is again the symbols. Okay. So this is this page, and then this... it begins with this page, okay. It seems no consequence that both the resting place of Pele and Pariacaca would happen to be in mountains. The trek has gone well, and although the winds are ominous, my clothing and necessities have carried me well so far. The guide I hired upon arrival has proved invaluable, not only in his knowledge of the thick forest, but also for his rich knowledge and his company. Not unexpectedly, this symbol of water could be found at the peak of the summit, along with the alchemic symbol of water. Again, these symbols seem interconnected, and while one set are alchemic symbols known to many people, the others seem strange and of no cultural design that at least I am knowledgeable of. The encounter in Hawaii makes me certain that the other two elements must bear significance as well. What will I find on this mountain? How the hell should I know? I can't, like, interact with the ladder, right? No. Alright, let's advance.
Celtic myths and legends.
Oh, brother. There's gotta be, 100 books here, and there's all the same 3 or 4 titles.
Grandpa loved reading maps. I wonder how many of these he charted or drew himself. Shu, Egypt. And a symbol of a... swirl? What a globe. Huh. Grandpa sure had some cool stuff that I've never seen. What are these strange markings and symbols?
I do not know, child.
What a globe. Huh. Grandpa sure had some cool... Fusang, China. And a symbol of a tree.
I sense a puzzle.
Fusang, China. And And a symbol of a tree. Hey, this is that goddess thing mentioned in Grandpa's diary.
What are these strange markings and symbols?
Pariyakaka, South America. And that looks like a drop of water.
She did a little better than me pronouncing that.
What a globe.
Oh.
Huh. Is that supposed to be wind? I'm guessing it's wind. Shu, Egypt. And a symbol of a swirl?
Okay, so he says two things here.
Fusang, China. And Fusang, China. And a Pele. Hey, Pele, Hawaii. And a fire symbol. Pariyakaka, South America. And that looks like a drop of water.
On a bike.
An old bicycle. I'm pretty sure this exact model is in fashion again. The rust just makes it more hip. An old bicycle. Hiking by train, I'm leaving by train. Hiking by train, I'm pretty sure this exact model is in fashion again. The rust just makes it more hip.
Page? Journal page. Number one. Okay, so it starts. I have definitely. Okay, the last two paragraphs are this. So it starts here. And it ends here with that symbol. I finally landed on Hawaii and will soon begin my arduous climb of Mauna Loa. I'm not much of a climber, but I am filled with determination. Determination! I will, however, first take some days to recuperate from the very tiresome trouble from which my fear of flights did not exactly improve. Not only was the pilot rude and dismissive of safety protocol, he also seemed completely unsure at times of what he was doing. That doesn't sound good. Regardless, I am here and will spend the coming days in the village of Pahala. Whatever secrets Pele, goddess of fire, holds, it is now within my grasp. I have definitely reached the right place, although I am weary from travel. I am too excited to sleep. The villagers are friendly, but warn me of hurting customs, something I have no intent to do. I have also noticed the alchemic symbol of fire etched over people's doorways. It connects to Pele, of course, but is it linked to the crest I've sought as well?
Whoa. This looks like it belongs in a museum.
In case you get a vampire coming along.
Or like a Scottish cathedral. Whoa. Nuh-uh. I've watched too many movies to go about stealing ancient relics. I prefer my face unmelted. Thank you very much.
There's a cross, not the Ark of the Covenant.
Nuh-uh. I'm
the hero with 1,000 faces.
A typewriter. Can't imagine it's been used much. Grandpa was always the fountain pen type. A typewriter.
Cute. Let's play some chess.
It's a chessboard, with the game already in progress. I wonder who's winning.
I wonder who's who.
Actually, I wonder who Grandpa was playing. It's a chessboard. There's no one to play. And I'm not sure I even know the proper rules.
She got louder there. Maybe he was playing against Pele.
There's no one to play. And I'm not sure I...
Fairies by Brian Froud and Alan Lee.
Oh, that was a scroll.
My grandfather's grandfather clock. How much wood would a woodchuck chuck if a... Grandpa loved this thing. Told me it was one of a kind. Although, he never actually told me why. Come to think of it, I don't even know where he got it from. On one of his travels, I guess.
It's been pretty heavy to, like, ship or carry with him?
I can't believe Mom wants to sell this. I get that he missed a lot of her childhood, but come on. I'd take it if I could. But where in my 18 square meter student apartment would I fit this thing?
You couldn't even carry it.
My grandfather's grandfather clock. There is no way I can pick this up. It weighs like 200 pounds.
Yeah, exactly.
There is no way I can pick this up. These books are all so old. Hey, wait. Is that the biography of George Lucas?
No, never. Okay, none of these are pages.
It's a landscape painting of Whittington. It's of a field just outside of the village. This one always gave me chills. I mean, it's beautiful and all, but it has this otherworldly feel to it.
I like it.
It's a landscape painting of Whittington. I am not taking this with me right now. I am not taking... It's a landscape painting of Whittington.
This one too?
It's of a farm not far from where Grandma used to work.
Oh, Sarah's things over there.
I wonder if it still looks the same.
This one looks a little less otherworldly.
It's a landscape paint. I am not taking this with me right now.
Stuff.
Ah, here's my stuff. These are the things I kept in Grandma and Grandpa's house. For whenever I'd spend some weeks of the summer here.
Oh, convenient to do it that way.
Man, it's gonna feel weird clearing all this stuff out. Ah, here's my stuff. I'm not grabbing my stuff until I've made sure I have everything I need in here. Oh man, my old A station. I spent hours playing games on this thing.
A station.
I must have played through The Adventures of Merida every single summer I was here.
We've got a message to play.
I wonder if it still works. Oh man, damn, the adapter's missing. Probably for the best. I wouldn't get anything done today if I started playing. These are the things I kept in Grandma and Grandpa's house. Hey, Mr. Piggles. How've you been holding up? Hey, Mr. Piggles.
So at first I thought it was a piggy bank. So these are the titles for her A station. Zoom in here. Yeah, it's like Legend of Zelda. Is that like Crash Bandicoot logo? Not sure. That looks like a Blade Runner or maybe 007 logo. I'm not sure. The only one I recognize for sure is Legend of Zelda. I'm gonna hit that, but don't worry. I can't open this thing. It looks like there's nothing else. Alright. Let's play this.
A tape recorder. The post-it says, "Play me." That's definitely Grandpa's handwriting. A tape recorder.
Hello. This is Howard James Wright with a message for my granddaughter, Sarah Elizabeth Wright.
Oh, still it's starting?
So if anyone else is listening, they can start off immediately, please. Sarah, if you are listening to this, then it means... Well, it means I'm gone. But I don't want you to be too sad about it. That's just the way life goes sometimes. So, chin up, my little pixie. Remember our grand moments. All the adventures we had when you were a little one and I wasn't such a cranky old man. I know you have questions for me. It's true I kept secrets from you and your mother. But there were good reasons. There are things in this world greater than ourselves, and I needed to protect you from them. I didn't want either of you to face the dangers that I've had to... I never wanted to place such a burden on your shoulders, but now it's unavoidable. Pixie, I need your help. But I can't just tell you. I have to show you. You will need to see for yourself. This world is full of secrets. From the tallest tree to the deepest river. In every breath of wind and every dancing flame. All you have to do is look. Goodbye, Sarah. I love you very much.
That's already so sad.
Goodbye, Grandpa.
So I took the cassette with me.
The post-it says, play me. That's definitely Grandpa's handwriting.
This world is full of secrets.
I took it out and he's still playing it.
Deepest river, in every breath of wind and every dancing flame. All you have
okay.
to do is look.
So it's the same text.
Goodbye,
here.
Bye, Sarah. I love you very much.
Well, can I put the pages in this then that I've collected?
Hele, goddess of fire. I should see if I can find the missing pages before moving this.
Alright, so we're missing pages. Am I correct in that we're gonna find them here upstairs in the attic? We're missing 3 and 4. There's 3 and 4.
There are 4 hands, and none of them are moving.
Oh.
That old man never could fix anything properly. There are 4 hands. It's locked. It needs a key to open. It's locked. It needs a key to open.
Alright, we need to find a key. I think we need to get in that desk. Unless there's something just... that we haven't seen.
It's an old table lamp.
I haven't looked here.
It's an old table lamp.
Oh, there's a key right there! Small key. Okay, sweet.
The key I have doesn't fit here.
Alright, maybe it goes to... Jeez, I wish I could move faster. Maybe it goes to the desk. Looks small enough to fit in the desk, maybe. Hello.
A desk drawer.
What you got?
Huh. This tin box looks fairly old.
Oh.
It has a combination lock on it.
Wonderful.
What could the combination be?
Yeah, what I wonder.
Okay, Grandpa. I need a clue to unlock this box. So if you're here... Huh. Guess I'll have to work it out myself then.
I thought I saw smoke. Oh, it was one of these motes floating around.
Huh. It's locked. It's locked.
Is it locked? Oh, it's a word. Elston, maybe? No. No. Is this, like, an actual word? You would think these would be vowels.
What could the Okay, Grandpa. I need a clue to unlock this box. So if you're here... Huh. Guess I'll have to work it out myself, then.
Okay, we've only got O and A here.
Huh. This tin box looks fairly old and has a combination lock. What could the combination be?
It might not be where it started out. Okay.
An open desk drawer. A desk drawer. An open desk drawer. An open desk drawer.
Okay, nothing valuable in there. Nor there. Nor there. Okay. So this one we opened already. What about this one? There's nothing in either of them now. Okay. We still got all these drawers.
A pretty fancy looking compass. I guess Grandpa used it a lot during his travels. A pretty fancy look- nah. I can find my way back to the train station without it.
Take the compass, will ya?
That's a really nice binocular. Monocular? Telescope. That's a really nice telescope.
It's a really small telescope.
A vest, me matey. Yar! That's a really nice telescope. This will be perfect for my next sail across the seven seas, but I'll leave it where it is for now.
What you got?
A torn out page. This seems to belong to the diary.
Ding! Let's just look at this first.
What's this?
I think it's a photo.
It's an old photograph. Must be from one of Grandpa's trips.
Zoom in.
What's this?
Grabbed it. A journal photograph. Here, let's put this. An old photograph found in Grandpa's desk. It says Sultan Hassan Mosque Madrasa. Egypt, 1966. Must have been from one of his trips. Egypt. Yeah, that's what it says. Sultan Hassan Mosque. Yeah. Alright, what's the one we picked up for? Yeah. Starts here. All I've worked for. It's here. I know it. The necklace in the temple in China made all the difference, and now I'm finally in Africa, hoping to set the burning sensation of curiosity to peace. The symbols line up and my calculations were correct. The anonymous mail I received helped on a grand scale, but I still have not managed to figure out the sender. Regardless, the last piece of knowledge should be here, in Egypt, and after having evaded my guide, I have now found the symbols. It's time. Time to learn what is behind these strange connections and events. Time to find page 3. That's what I say.
An open desk drawer.